Contrary to what most of us have heard, the Apostle Peter did not start the church in Rome. But what about Peter being the first pope, you may ask? After all, wasn't I told that Peter was in Rome and started the church there? Well, believe it or not, Paul, not Peter, was the apostle to the Romans. Let's notice Romans chapter 1 here, and in verse 1. We read, Paul, a bondservant of Jesus Christ, called to be an apostle. And then as we drop down to verse 11, he says this, For I long to see you, that I may impart to you some spiritual gift, so that you may be established. If Peter was in Rome, he would have established the church, and there would have been no reason for Paul to establish it. Also, if Peter had been living in Rome when this was written, why did he not mention Peter? In fact, in chapter 15, if we just turn over there to chapter 15, and in verse 20, we read an interesting statement by Paul. He said, And so I have made it my aim to preach the gospel, not where Christ was named, lest I should build on another man's foundation. Paul was telling the Romans that he would not step into another man's area of responsibility. And notice also in chapter 16, we find Paul mentioning all of the members of the congregation in Rome by name. But there's no mention of Peter. Wouldn't have that been a snub to him? There were some Jews in Rome, but the majority of the names that we read in chapter 16 are either Latin or Greek. They were Gentiles, not Jewish, and Paul, not Peter, was the apostle to the Gentiles. Now, the reality is that Peter was amongst the Jews in Babylon and later amongst the lost 10 tribes in Asia Minor. Did you know that he visited another important area of Israelite population? Where was that? Well, to understand this, we must go back to reliable historical sources. George Jowett wrote the following in his book, Drama of the Lost Disciples, on page 174. Listen to what George Jowett has to say. He said, There is plenty of evidence to show that Peter visited Britain and Gaul several times during his lifetime. His last visit to Britain taking place shortly before his final arrest and crucifixion in Nero's circus in Rome. Further proof of Peter's sojourn in Britain was brought to the light of day in recent times when an ancient, time-worn monument was excavated at Whithorn. On the face is an inscription that reads, The Place of St. Peter the Apostle. But why would Peter go to Britain when it was so far away from Jerusalem? The answer will surprise you. Many of the descendants of the ancient Israelite tribe of Joseph had already settled in Britain. Peter was simply following Jesus Christ's commission for him to go to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. By the time of Peter's visit to Britain, the British race was made up of descendants of the lost 10 tribes. They were to be joined later by their fellow Israelites in 449 AD when the Saxons arrived from Europe. Now, the name Saxon is a contraction of the name Isaac's son. You can see how that goes. Isaac's son becomes Saxon. And to this day, we find the name Saxon all over Britain. We can find Essex, which means East Saxons, Sussex, South Saxons, and Middlesex for the Saxons living near London.